Alright, so we're doing another E3 games I'm excited for, and just gonna go and get into it. We have the Star Wars reveals.
As a studio, our promise to gamers is ultimately gameplay first. We all demand that the game has these huge wow moments that translates really well into the Star Wars universe. We're gonna deliver.
Make a game that is set in the Star Wars universe, but to really tell an authentic Star Wars story. And that's actually a hugely different thing.
It's like a film director in many ways, because she is telling her story and I'm helping to realize her world.
They showed off. Well, didn't show off, that's kind of the point. They're doing respawns. It's a new Star Wars game, and they're doing the action adventure movie Star Wars 1313 replacements, or different action game, whatever. Also, barely mentioned Battlefront 2, and that would have 7 and Rogue One content, and maybe prequels. They didn't say really. Anyway, very excited for what Respawn will do, and 1313 is good, and so this other action game, but they didn't show off a lot. And Battlefront 2 would probably be good with the extra content and all that. But now let's just say, so this is just a quick thing. So next we have Prey.
Good morning, Morgan. Today is Monday, March 15th, 2032. You have a 9 a.m. appointment with Alex in his office. There is no duration set for this meeting. There is a 3 p.m. meeting in Transtar Conference Room A to greenlight research and development plans. Please confirm your attendance prior to arrival. Good morning, Morgan. Today is Monday, March 15th, 2032. You have a 9 a.m. appointment with Alex in his office. There is no.
Good morning, Morgan. You're not going to like what I have to say next.
I'm mostly excited about this because of Prey 2. Saw a commercial for, it's like space bounty kind of thing. But then they showed this thing, which is like a sci-fi mystery weird thing, whatever. Which also looks good, but I really, maybe they'll throw in some space bounty kind of thing or. I doubt it, but this other game looks good as well. The space goo. Actually, For Honor.
It's the essence of the Viking warrior. Now we're facing a Shugoki, a massive samurai warrior with a cannibal as a weapon. He's kind of slow, but you better be dodging his attacks because if he hits you, he hits you really hard. You can use the environment to your advantage. That's an unlucky guy. One hit is enough to kill your enemy when striking from above.
Right. Now you will pay!
Time to fight Saburo. He's one of the many bosses that you'll encounter in For Honor's campaign.
It should also end the campaign that there's like kind of weird kind of story, you know, like developed and stuff, not just some random battles. Yeah, so I'm excited for this game, but it's been around a while and gonna come out somewhat soon. So, still excited. Next we have Resident Evil 7. So, I played about Resident Evil 1 and RE0, the remakes, the newest remakes, and I liked them. I know that RE went down a different path of, like, not great action game, opposed to the horror, slow stuff, and all this doesn't look like it's technically going back to the... I did play the demo, by the way, so it's not going back completely to the old, turn and shoot and stuff, but it's going back to, what's going to this new horror, complete horror with a bit of survival stuff. I'd imagine there'd still be, like, guns and things, because on the demo there was, slot to quick use items, and then I wouldn't imagine that they'd be using it to click select items and like the lock chain cutters. So probably somewhat like old shooting games, but the new direction looks good. And yeah. So we have the Spider-Man game.
You're right.
This looked pretty good. I do like the old Spider-Man games and like the Spider-Man 2, even like some of the newer ones were pretty decent. The web swinging and all the fighting and stuff, and now they have like this thing where it looks like he can like jump off walls and stuff. Anyway, so all the old stuff. Trying real hard with like this MCU like Spider-Man. Looks good. And she had the Watch Dogs 2.
And emit a sound to attract the guards. Custom-made melee weapon, the Thunderball, to knock out the guard. Picard's computer to take down our opposition. The exit strategy Wrench set up for us is one of many ways the player could use to leave the penthouse.
On your stitching crew, I'm miles ahead of you. You can sip dripping from Gotham. Yes, it clips by the shadows of dark.
And I'd say this game looks pretty good. I liked Watch Dogs 1, but Watch Dogs 2 looks like it's like going with like this hipstery teen type thing. I will probably be more excited when like all these hipsters and like one thing I liked about, I thought Watch Dogs 1 was good. I know people didn't like it, but it was a decent game, you know, but it was repetitive. some things I liked about it were like how you have like Ian Pierce being like this lone vigilante type thing, but which I thought was good. And also, some people don't like Chicago, but I thought it was more interesting, and it wasn't another one of the 10,000 games that takes place in LA or New York. So that's good. Yeah, I know the old one was repetitive and stuff. And people don't like the AMP's character, which I don't know, like I sort of like appreciated more serious tone. And people like sort of like don't like the, they'd rather have their happy go lucky Nathan Drake's, you know, but I sort of appreciated that, even though like could see why people don't appreciate this less emotional hero, but it was like a creative route in a way. So people don't like this uncaring people, sort of, but it's kind of better that he wasn't like this perfect sociable person, as what I liked. So people like the new protagonist didn't look bad, I'm saying, but I think this game looks pretty decent, but just a lot of hipster stuff. Next we have Sea of Thieves.
The main mast cells still need to go down.
Oh, they're down.
We're sailing!
Oh, they're right on top!
Oh! Oh, no! Whoa!
We're sinking.
Oh, dude, we're gonna drown. It's water down here.
What do we do?
I don't know. Bail!
Yeah!
Let's go!
I thought this game looked good, like the ship battles and like each player, and so this video saw a bit more of how players had to do their individual dodges, of like not to raise the sails and scout stuff and poke holes, and so this game looks good. It's not a lot of new stuff. Still seeing the good stuff. Next we have Battlefield 1. This game looks pretty good. Like, Battlefield's like not the greatest shooter, but it's pretty solid, and they're going back to World War One and with the old wars and stuff. World One's a bit more untouched. So, and they got all the, it's a pretty good game, and they got the old stuff, and they got the big vehicles and the horses. Train looks good, and like the Zeppelin crashes and all that, and that's about it. Next we got COD, Call of Duty, Infinite Warfare.
Captain on the bridge.
Get us underway, Salt.
Right away, sir.
Captain has a con.
Raven 1 docking?
You're touching down now, ma'am.
Good. Station time, 1 minute.
Roger that.
We've got 4 new hotspots on radar, sir.
You said, Ethan?
Good to go, sir.
We're lit.
Launch in 3, 2, 1.
Air launch! No joy.
Easy, Saul. Easy.
I'm getting boxed in, Raider. Throttle up!
Coming to you. Got a shot.
2, 1. Go! 1, 2, away.
1-1 is away.
Bridge, dead ahead, sir.
Rog, let's get there.
We got hostiles. More incoming.
We
Curtis.
Also called U, which is abbreviation. So this game looks good. It's just like you being a captain of the ship and you fly the plane and grapple through space. It looks good. It's just a real good sci-fi. Now I just hope they don't a lot of potential for having like a good space shooting and space planes, but the multiplayer or the campaign might disappoint. Like Black Ops 3 is pretty disappointing. With like, I just don't want to make it bad with the combat with the slow, clunky Black Ops 3 gameplay or not balanced right. Next we have Dishonored 2.
Dishonored 2, encouraging players to explore the rooftops above the streets. Out of my ears.
You aren't doing it!
So dead!
Let
me get the rope for you!
Hey you! Come here!
Here, it will affect all of them. There are many creative ways to use Domino. Now we're going to show you Shadow Walk, another key power for Emily. You can watch enemies in the alternate timeline and then step through to execute your plans.
Really like Dishonored 1, and this looks like it brings a lot more stuff and a lot of new stuff. Probably looks like it plays well. All the powers and stuff. There's two characters this time. And also, there's like some sort of like time jump in and out thing, which also looks good. So I'm not sure how much that'll be used. Overall, good game. Next we have Titanfall 2.
Let's do this!
Stick together!
Go, go!
Protocol.
very excited for this game. Titanfall was my favorite game. So look, they got all the good stuff. They got all the shooting, and now they have grappling hooks and like can use like a Spider-Man web swing type thing and usually get up places. And they got new guns, new hovering. They got other like new like powers like teleport and the. Actually, that sensor grenade is probably just a grenade. Or maybe replaces a power. I don't know. Titanfall seem a bit weaker, but they're probably stronger. You know. Also, the campaign. Campaign's pretty good. Campaigns are good to have. It looks like a pretty good one, too. It's a real solid sci-fi. And you're like playing as one of the rifle guys. You're playing with like one of those little guys that you can kill really easy and scatter across the battlefield to make it look big. Okay, and so now you become like one of those guys, like a pilot. You're Optimus Prime like robot friend who can throw you and get your sword, which probably seems to only be in the multiplayer, but that's fine. And only be in the single player, but that's fine. Anyway, so it looks pretty good. And that's about it for E3. Do you see E3? Some other games. Probably. Side Titanfall 2, nothing that. It was extremely. Great, but not too bad. Pretty good year. That's it. That's what's there. Yeah.